Now it's pleural effusion, and this is also a common case appearing in the Paces exam. Many of you can get, and the command can be again the patient presented with breathing difficulty, examine the chest, and you will follow all of your scheme and do not omit any part, and you will come to the diagnosis. Okay, and as I have explained, your diagnosis, you will make your diagnosis on the basis of auscultation in respiratory system, and mainly auscultation of the back. Okay, so you will look for all the features for respiratory disease, and look for all any sign of any cause of pleural effusion. And if you find on inspection, there are many signs, and which I will explain shortly, and you can see on observation, on inspection, and then when you will examine, further signs you will find, and then you can make your diagnosis. Okay, so now how you will present this, I am going to tell you a general presentation. Now whatever signs your patient is having, you can add or subtract. Okay, depends upon what your patient is having. Okay, so I will like to complete my examination by checking sputum part, doing bedside spirometry, doing looking pulse oximetry, taking occupational and drug history. On examination of this gentleman, I found that he is not breathless, at rest, and trachea is centered in position. On examination of the chest, this chest expansion is reduced with dull percussion note and decreased vocal resonance with decreased breath sound and with dull percussion note in the right lower base, and there is bronchial breathing above the area of dullness. So on the basis of this, my diagnosis is patient is having right sided pleural effusion. Okay, so like this you will present, and if your patient is having any cause, like patient is of old age and is cachectic, and you feel you felt lymph node, then you can say that cause could be malignancy. If your malignancy of lung, it could be lymphoma or any malignancy. If there is female, you can offer to check for the breast, or you can look for mastectomy. Okay, maybe she her is removed. You can look for rheumatoid hands, because this is also one of the cause. Any stigmata of chronic liver disease or chronic renal failure or CCF, if you found, then you can comment on the cause as well. And while presenting, so you will present in one line. Okay, like dull percussion note, reduced chest expansion, decreased vocal resonance, and decreased breath sound in the right lower side. You will not say like this that chest expansion is reduced in the right side, percussion note is dull on the right side, vocal resonance is reduced on the right side. No, this is not the way. This is not the professional way. Okay, so now few things I want to tell you, that if in the respiratory station, like many things you have to see, menace, with every topic I am telling. And here you will see if the patient is having on oxygen or not, and when you are asking patient to cough, then you will see if the cough is productive, then it can give you a clue that it could be due to bronchiectasis mainly or malignancy. Okay, and if patient is cachectic, then it could be a sign of malignancy mainly. And how to look for cachexia, this already I have explained. You will look for temporal wasting and tricep skin fold thickening. Okay, and you will look for finger clubbing, and if again there is clubbing, then it will there is a clue that malignancy could be a cause. Nicotine staining you will see, and you can again, it could point that malignancy or airway obstructive lung disease could be the cause. And you can look for any stigmata of rheumatological disease. There are many stigmata of rheumatological disease. This when I will explain you about rheumatology, then I will explain you. Okay, and you can look for elevated venous pressure. It could signify pulmonary hypertension, maybe due to secondary to respiratory disease or heart disease. And if you felt lymph nodes, then it could signify infection or malignancy. Okay, and tracheal position you will assess. Trachea will be shifted in if the fusion is large, otherwise it will remain central. And look carefully for the scars for the previous biopsies and intercostal drainage, okay? And look for radiotherapy marks as well, and peripheral edema. And peripheral edema will say point towards many things like hypoalbuminemia, congestive cardiac failure, okay? So these are the points which you have to keep in your mind while looking any respiratory disease, okay? And especially pleural effusion, and there are many causes of pleural effusion you all will be knowing, exudative and transudative. Like transudative, protein is less than 30 gram per liter, then at least 5 causes you should know: CCF, hyperalbuminemia, nephrotic syndrome, cirrhosis, uremia, hypothyroidism. And for the exudative, if protein is more than 30 gram per liter, and the causes could be neoplasia, connective tissue disorders, infections, pulmonary infarctions, and drug, okay? Now I will tell you high yield causes. There is a list of causes for exudative and transudative. This is all theoretical purpose. If examiner asks, then you can tell. But I will tell you high yield causes which you have to see in your patient. You have to see for malignancy. As I have explained, it could be carcinoma of lung, lymphoma, or carcinoma of breast if it is the female. And you will look for mastectomy even. You can look for mastectomy scar. And you will look for cachexia, lymph node, temporal wasting, tricep skin fold thickening, okay, and age. You can look for any stigmata of rheumatological disease, especially for rheumatoid arthritis and SLE, okay. Rheumatoid hands, SLE rash and red eyes, many things for both of these conditions. But mainly remember these two, like any arthropathy of the hand or any rash on the face, okay. So any stigmata of chronic liver disease, like if you see jaundice or edema, or or any stigmata of chronic liver disease. There are many stigmatas. This, when I explained you chronic liver disease, I explained all. And hypoalbuminemia, if there is peripheral edema, again it will signify hypoalbuminemia. And congestive cardiac failure in case of raised venous pressure and peripheral edema, okay. So this is, and now what is a differential diagnosis? Next question of the examiner will be, what is a differential diagnosis of dullness or dull percussion note at the lung base? Okay, so you can give a list of differential. Sir, it could be pleural effusion, pleural thickening, collapse, consolidation, raised hemidiaphragm, lobectomy, and hemothorax, okay. And you should know about Light's criteria. This they are asking very much, okay. Like pleural fluid protein to serum protein ratio is more than 0.5, pleural fluid LDH to serum LDH ratio more than 0.6, and pleural fluid LDH more than 2/3 of the upper limit of the normal serum value, okay. So this is Light's criteria. And how you will diagnose pleural effusion? Now the tests are same as for every respiratory disease which I have explained. Like you will start from the blood test, and all the tests for the causes, and this I have explained in the ILD, okay. Please listen to that audio, and the same way you will explain the tests. And for every test you will tell the reason also, like full blood count, looking for anemia, leukocytosis, polycythemia, urine electrolyte, any test you want to do, you have to tell the reason. Arterial blood gases, pleural tap, chest x-ray, CT scan, bronchoscopy, mammogram, CT chest, CT abdomen, like this. All tests you have to tell, okay. This I have explained already, so right now I will not explain. And if 180 ml of pleural effusion fluid should be, then it can be detected on the chest x-ray. And if there is small pleural effusion, then how you will diagnose? We will use a lateral decubitus view, okay. Lateral film we will use, and we can do ultrasound as well, okay. And so how you will manage the management is again the same, like journal and specific. And journal always patient education, counseling, explanation of the condition, giving immunization, avoiding smoking and occupational hazard if there is any, and treating the respiratory infections. And specific management includes medical and surgical. The medical management includes taking care for the diet and giving diuretics, and we can think for pleural tap, pleurodesis and surgical decortication if there is empyema. Okay, so like this you can explain the management of pleural effusion. And what are the indications for pleurodesis? These are recurrent malignant pleural effusion and recurrent pneumothoraces. Okay, and what are the complications of pleural fluid drainage? This is pneumothorax, hemothorax, hypovolemia and unilateral pulmonary edema. Okay, like if the effusion is large, then you can drain it as well. This you all know. And what to look for in the pleural tap, this also you all know, like protein, LDH, glucose, pH, amylase, cholesterol, ZNS staining, microscopy culture, cytology. Okay, so these things you have to see. So I hope this was all about pleural effusion. And if pleural fluid LDH is more than 1000 international unit per liter, then what are the causes? The causes include empyema, malignant effusion, rheumatoid effusion. Okay, and causes for hemorrhagic pleural effusion: malignancy, pulmonary embolus, tuberculosis and chest trauma.
Please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you.